Hey everybody, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4, the Noob to Expert series with Scott and me, Scryptar. How you doing, Scott?
Very good. How you doing?
I'm doing fine. You're conquering Ethiopia, I've heard.
Yeah, we're gonna give that a shot.
Yeah, so we've set everything up in between the last episode and this one, right on stream. So if you want to see us struggle and try to guess what's happening because we can't see each other, you've missed the stream. That's your fault. Totally. Alright, so I'm going to go through this quickly again, since Scott now basically is an expert on how to assign armies to a frontline. I'm going to do it right here, right now, so everybody else can see it. So, let's do that. Alright, I've already set up two armies here, just for starters. Let's have a quick look on how to do that if you want to start fresh. You can select troops just by dragging your mouse around them. That says we have some selected here. No, it's up here. Four divisions. And then you can say form an army. And there we go. That's our army 3. Four divisions. They are in purple, as it says up here, and as it also says over here in the theater. That's all you need to know for now. That's how you do an army. There's more ways to do this. That's one of them. What you always want to do with an army is to assign them somewhere, so you can set up a front line here. This front line will cover, when you just left click, the whole of the Netherlands to German border. It will not go beyond that, because, you know, just because you're hostile towards the Netherlands doesn't mean you're hostile towards Belgium. Unless you're Germany, then it does. But the game doesn't know that. Alright, so what the armies will do, or what this army will do now, those divisions, those five that are in this army, will go and try to cover this whole front. That's basically the first thing you need to know about that. How do you get all your divisions to join up in an army? Because currently you can't do anything with them. If you just click on one of these divisions, there is no buttons to press. You can't do anything with them. You need them to be in an army. So how does that work? There is a button on top that says unassigned divisions. If you click on that multiple times, it will scroll through all the different unassigned divisions that you have. If you shift click, it will select all of those that are not yet assigned to an army, and then you can just go and, at the bottom, hit plus on create new army, and that's it. The icon will disappear on top. All of your units are now assigned to an army. Or, you can just drag across the whole screen and get them all selected, and you see now on the bottom I have four armies. I'm just going to right-click on one of them. As it says here, right-click to assign the selected divisions, and all of them will be in this army. So all of my units are now in Army 1, with Erwin Rommel as their general. And it says here, I have 30 out of 24 possible divisions in this army. I get penalty of 25%, which is huge. So you don't really want to do that, right? Now, let's start this fresh. We're going to remove this army. Everybody is unassigned now. I'm going to press escape here to clear the screen. And I don't have an army. I don't have a theater. And the button comes up, unassigned divisions. I also need to select a focus. Really? I completely missed that. I had something special I wanted to do. That. I'm going to get into focus and why I choose them later. Currently, I'm just going to do them to show you that they're running. All right. So, we're going to select all of the units, shift left click on unassigned divisions, put them in an army, and it says we have 30. Now we're going to assign a commander, and as I said before, if you sort by capacity, you get your field marshals on top. And the field marshals do not have the limitation of 24 divisions. So let's see, who are we going to take? Obviously one with a better skill, and I'm going to take that guy. Gerd von Rundstedt. So now, as you can see, there is no penalty whatsoever. Everybody is assigned to this one guy. That's your army. That's all about that. So, Scott, you couldn't really follow with that, but, you know, we've done it between streams. You know roughly what you're doing there, right?
Yeah, I set up the one in Italy. Cool. While you were doing that, following you, and I set all that up.
Mm-hmm. And we've done colors and icons and stuff like that, so I'm just going to do this and this. And now you see them here. 30, all red. Nice. So on your main map, you actually see on the very right of those divisions, they have a red bar or a green bar or whatever your army color actually is. And at the bottom, where you have the portrait of your field marshal or general, it also has a colored bar to the left and right of that guy, showing the army color. That's how you find them. Good. These guys are going to have one frontline over here, so you left click on frontline, or shortcut is Z. Always work with shortcuts in this game. There are very, very many shortcuts, so if I hit Z, I get the same again. So I have two frontlines set now. One says 30 divisions attached to this frontline, because I had them all selected. They immediately get sent over here. And the other one just says no divisions, and the frontline looks a little bit different, a little striped. That's just to show you that this frontline is empty, there's nobody here. Now, how am I going to reassign units to that division? I want those four that are already up here in Ostpreußen to stay on this frontline. So I'm just going to drag my mouse around them. So on the left side, you can see I have only four selected now. And then I'm going to hover over this frontline. It says here, control right click to select units assigned to this order. There are no units, so we can't do that. But control click, which is left click, to assign selected units to this order. So control left click. And these four are now here, and they get subtracted over here, so there's now 26 remaining on that one. That's not enough, though. I don't want four over there, I want more. Let's take these two, then you can hold a shift and drag some more. So let's take these, and let's take these. So now I have five selected, and I'm going to control left click over here, and now it's nine. That's how we do that. 20 here, nine there. That should hold the pocket open for a while. Alright, I'm going to do some other stuff here. If I look at my army, there is different units in this army, which you can see by the icon. You have a helmet, you have a tank, you have a truck. You should see the same for your armies, basically. If you click on the general or field marshal in the bottom, and it gives you the list of units on the left side.
Yes.
And you see that they all have different icons, or well, some of them probably have.
Oh, they do.
Mm-hmm. If you double left click where it says the name of that division, so 23rd Infantry or 1st Panzer or whatever.
Okay.
Just double left click. Then you select all the units that are of the same type.
Okay.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to double left click on my tanks, well, where it says 1st, 2nd, 3rd Panzer Division. And if I scroll up and down, I see I only have those three. That makes it easy. I'm going to split those off into a new army by just clicking the plus on the bottom. And they are now a new army. I'm going to give them a new commander. Sort by skill. And that commander will be Erich von Manstein. Because he has some unique abilities here that we're going to go through soon. Okay, those guys are just basically going to sit here. They have been deducted from this front line. They are not used anymore. That's good. Alright, so you can do the same if you want. You can split your army off into separate... Well, armies that are specific unit types, that's one of the ways to do it, basically. So you can have a horse division, you can have a mountaineer division, you can have a paratrooper division, all of that. And all assign them to separate armies. If you want to, you don't really have to. It's not really necessary for you at this stage.
Okay.
Good. So what am I going to do with those guys? Let's have a quick look here. They are all in good order. If you open up one of your armies, let's go through this real quick. And you look at the left-hand side, you have two bars, a green and an orange bar. Then you have the icon of the army, which is a helmet here, for example. And the next icon after that gives you the experience level. You see what I mean?
Experience level 3, regular.
Regular.
Level 2.
Mm-hmm. There's different icons for those levels. Level 3 is what you want to see, because that's the maximum you can achieve through training. You can get into higher levels, but only through combat. What you don't want to see is the clover leaf, which basically tells you those units are green.
Yeah, I have four of those.
Yeah, if you hover over that, it tells you minus 25% combat modifier, right?
Yes.
So that means, even if these units are at 100% strength, they will only do 75% of the defense and offense they could.
Okay.
Because they're green. That's just how that works. So... for those, I hope you have all of those in a separate army and not mixed up with the Ethiopian War going on.
Actually, they're the ones in the Ethiopian War.
Oh, that's just, you know, that's bad for them because you're not going to be able to do what we want to do.
They're going to die.
Mm-hmm. Okay, do you have any that are not green but also not experienced? That should be the other yellow icon you get there.
Ethiopian one, yes.
Yeah, but in your home army in Italy?
I will head up there and see. What do I got here? Let's select you. I got one green, I got level 2s, and level 3s.
Good. So you at least have some of the level 2s in there. That's great. They don't have any combat modifiers, just plus minus 0. But you want to probably get them to a better level so they actually get a plus 25 because they're experienced, right?
Right.
So what you're going to do is on top, you see where it, where it says select all, and above that there's four buttons?
Yes.
The leftmost button, that those little two guns with the gear wheel in the back, that will exercise your army. Now what that does is basically, it exercises those troops. They will not be really combat ready when you exercise them, but it will heighten their experience level. Now, like I said, they can't get any higher than experience level 3 by doing that, but at least they get up to there. So that's something you could do straight away.
And that's okay to do that now?
If
with my home troops.
With your home troops, if you don't do that with the Ethiopian troops, otherwise you will lose that war in 2 seconds.
Yeah.
I'm not going to do that just now because I just don't have anybody here to train. I will do that in a second when I change some stuff over. We'll get there. So, I am going to attack Warsaw, Poland, someday. So, I'm going to select the right army, which is the red one. That's the red front lines over here. I'm going to say offensive line. I'm going to say go here. And I do that by right-clicking on, and dragging. And you see this... this offensive line now says 18 divisions going along this arrow over to this area. That's what I want. I'm going to do the same again. I'm going to go offensive line and say, you guys, you should just break out up here. And as you see, the arrow moves from one front line to the other. If that's the wrong front line, you just hit tab a couple of times and it will move between all the different, well, areas of attack origins it can come from. Well, I'm quite happy to have this start over here. That's good. And I will say 9 divisions attached over here and 18 divisions attached down here, which is the same number that I have stationed on these front lines. You always want to check that, because it might be that you have separate front lines and separate attack plans. If I do another one right now and say you should come from there, this will be empty because all divisions on this front are already assigned over here. They can't go over there. So then I would have to go and manually select some and say go over here. But we come to that once we actually have a war going on. For now, all you need to know is that this is how it works. Gorgeous. That's going to be our main line of attack right here. Except for the tanks. Perfect. Okay. So, that's how you form your army, group up your army, and give them the basic orders to attack another country. That's good to know when you're Germany, right? That's what you want to do, I heard. Somebody told me. Okay, what else do we need to know about? Resources, obviously. If you go in your production menu again, the little green wrench on top.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You see that in every of your production lines on the right-hand side, it tells you that it uses resources. So if you have infantry equipment, that uses 30 units of steel, for example.
Yeah.
If you go only one factory, it will be only 2 units of steel. Actually, if you hover over your factory assignment slots there, and you hover over the top left one, the number on the right side will change. You don't even need to click. So that's basically your preview telling you, okay, if I do this, if I only assign this one, I'm only going to produce 5 guns a day and it will cost me 2 steel. And if I'm going to do all 15, I will produce almost 80 guns per day and I will use 30 units of steel. And some of these numbers, for me at least, when I go down here, are in red because we don't have enough. So I'm missing oil quite heavily and I'm missing rubber quite heavily.
Oh, me too.
If you look at the very top, right where it says production, right below that, it gives you a summary of all resources in the game. There are 6 different types. There's oil, there's rubber, there's steel, there's aluminium, not aluminum, it's aluminium, guys, get it right, tungsten, and chromium. You see that, right?
Yes.
Green numbers, you have a surplus. Red numbers, you're missing. So that already tells you how much you are missing. That if you're missing something, it's usually bad. Because you can't produce full efficiency if you're missing the resources, right? If you're trying to produce guns and you don't have steel, what are you going to do? Use clay? That probably shatters by the first time you fire them. Well, it might be a Russian AK, you never know. They work even when you throw them in the mud. But, you know, in general, if you're missing resources, you can't work full efficiency. So it will give you a reduction on how much you can do. So if you find one of those factory lines there, where you have a red number for resources, and yes, if you then hover your mouse over the X amount of day produced, you get a pop-up saying our 4 military factories contribute so and so much to whatever you're producing there, production efficiency so and so much percent, and below that it says lack of resources, for me, minus 50.7%. So I'm currently only producing half of what I could, even though I have all the factories in there, because I'm missing 2 out of 3 resources here. And this should probably be the same for you with slightly different numbers.
Yeah, I have, for my tanks, it's lack of resources minus 3.50%.
Mm-hmm. For my battleship, it's minus 100%.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good. I got minus 24 on mine.
So resources are important somehow. Yes. If you don't have enough resources, you can import resources, and you're already automatically exporting resources. So we're going to go do that now. On the very top, there's a light blue button with a parcel and 2 arrows. That's called trade. Let's click on that for a second.
Alrighty.
Yeah, you get lots of numbers now, right?
Yep.
All right. First of all, you see here the same icons of the resources, where you see you have I have minus 30 oil and I have minus 7 rubber. Some of these numbers are in red, some are in green, and some are in yellow. You might not have the yellow ones. You may.
I don't have the yellow.
Good. Below that it says extracted, imported, exported, and production, right? On the very left-hand side, it gives you like 4
okay,
rows.
Yes, yes, mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
Good. What's important here? The imported and the exported is important, usually. So imported mostly says 0, I guess.
Yes, imported mm-hmm. is all 0s.
And exported usually gives you a red number with a minus. So for me, it's like yep. minus 40 aluminium. That means that somebody is getting 40 aluminium from me. Why? Because we have a trade market. And there's no real war going on currently. So somebody actually sends me something to get 40 aluminium from me, which is okay. That's how the, you know, that's how the open market works. If you need more of something, so for example, oil, I have minus 30. You click on that oil icon, or below it has the same tabs with the same resource icons in there. You click on that oil icon, works for me as well.
Okay.
And then at the bottom you get a list of countries, right?
Yes, I do.
You want to click on the export tab twice, so it's sorted by whoever exports the most. And that should usually be for oil, the United States.
Yes.
Because all the oil comes from Texas. And then you have the Soviet Union and Venezuela and whatnot. Right?
Yes. Yep.
Good. So you want to import oil. So you click on your, you clicked on export, you've done that. And then you just click somewhere in that line where it says United States. And you get another pop-up.
Yep.
Good. It says United States on top. And then it says United States can export up to so and so much of oil. We can only trade up to so and so much units. Right?
Yes.
All right. For exporting, or in your case, importing, because you want to get that from somebody, you need convoys. On the very top of your screen, in the middle, there is an icon that looks like a ship.
Yes.
And there's a number next to it. That tells you how many convoys you have.
Okay.
The same number is in that text box there. We have that number, available convoys, and we require however many for this trade.
All right.
That's the first thing you need to know. The second thing you need to know is that you need to give up civilian factories for every trade you do. So if you want to have oil from another state, you need to give them a civilian factory, or, well, lease them a civilian factory in return. That's how this works. That's your currency. That's why you okay. always want to have some civilian factories. And the way this works is for 8 units of whatever resource, 1 civilian factory. So if you buy 32, you need to spend 4 civilian factories for that. You cannot use them, you cannot build roads with them, you cannot build military factories with them, you cannot build new civilian factories with them. They're gone, they're not there. So you're getting 32 oil and they are getting 4 civilian factories to make bread boxes or kitchen knives or whatever.
Okay.
At the bottom it has a slider, and the left it says 0, and in the right it says however your max import will be. And right. this automatically calculates. So if I look this up on my screen, it says I have minus 30 oil. due to the fact that you can only do installments of 8, it says buy amount is 32. And that's 4 factories. Now, if I don't want to spend 4 factories, I can click the arrow to the left and it says, okay, now you're spending 3 and you're only getting 24. And I could say, well, I'm still missing 6, but maybe that's not that big a malus than having minus 30. So you could do that. The easiest thing, there's this little clipboard icon. You just click on that once and it says, okay, whenever you do this, I will just send them the factories and you will get the oil to make this plus minus 0, more or less. And then you say send. And that's it. Okay. And now they will start, these convoys will start going to the US of A and start importing your resources. The thing to be aware of is when you are at war, these convoys will go through sea, right? That's what they do.
Yes, they do.
So mine usually go through the English Channel, because that's the shortest route. There's both France and the UK. Those two are usually not friendly when I'm at war, because I'm usually at war with them. They will shoot down my convoys. They will just sink them, and I will not get my resources. The civilian factories are spent. They are over in the US doing their work. But I will still not get my resources. So that's one of the things you have to be aware of. There is the option, if you have neighboring countries, like Russia, for example, would also be able to sell oil. If Poland, which is between me and Russia, if Poland is neutral, they will allow shipment of oil to pass through their territory. Which then means I don't need convoys because they are going over land. So in that case, nobody will be able to shoot down my resources. I will just get them. That's the only difference, really. So if I could get, I don't know, aluminium or steel from France, that's right bordering my territory. No convoys. I just need to exchange my civilian factories for their steel. That's it. If I go to war with France, well, the import will usually be cancelled because they usually don't supply the enemy with war effort material. Alright, I'm gonna do the same for rubber. I click on rubber and say, yeah, just import it from British Malaya, doesn't matter. And I do have a surplus of a tungsten. It says here I have a yellow 10, and I'm importing 8, so I click on that. I click on the little clipboard here again, which doesn't do anything for me right now. Okay, I just set it down to 0 manually and say, okay, don't import that. And I'm still in the green right now. Good, that's fine. That's resource importing. You done with that?
Sounds good.
Mm-hmm. So that's episode 3, and we still haven't started playing the game, right?
Well, you gotta learn to set it up before you can roll it all.
And the interesting thing is, once you know how that works, this will be the first 3 minutes of every game.
Yep.
Selecting your army, making your front lines, getting your resources done, getting your initial military factories set up, starting to produce infrastructure and all that, and getting your first research and your first first focus tree item set up. And then you usually just hit play and wait for things to unfold. And yeah, if you want to explain that and if you want to get some details, then it takes 3 episodes. Then you take an hour. That's okay. It's fine with me. Good. So, yeah, you know how this works. For those in the stream, don't go anywhere. We continue straight away. For those watching the video, though, that's it for this episode. Don't forget to justify a subscriber goal. Blitzkrieg that like button. Follow me on Twitter if you want to catch the next live stream. I'm Scryptar, he is Scott, and you are dismissed.